Hi everybody, in this video we are going to learn how to print in AutoCAD from the layout tabs, and we will see some great tips that you can implement in your projects. So let's start. We are going to use the floor plan from the sample files. Click on this arrow in Open. Explore sample drawings. Then go to Database Connectivity. Click on Floor Plan Sample. Then in this window you have to click on Yes. And here you have the file. Now we can save this in our computer. Click on the application icon, save as, then click on Drawing. And now just save it with the name that you wish, in an easy location for you. Now I'm going to switch to the layout one. As you can notice, we can see here a sheet of paper with a rectangle with the drawing. This is the place to print a project. The first thing is to ensure the paper size is correct. Right-click on Layout 1. Then go to Page Setup Manager. In this window that just opened, make sure you select the correct layout and click on Modify. This is the Page Setup window. Then, in this tab, we need to select the paper size from the list. I will keep the current one as this file is in inches, but if you are working on metrical units, you can choose one of these ones of the ISO format. Finally, select your own printer. In my case, I'm going to choose the option DWG to PDF, as I want to create a PDF file first. Then click on OK to close. OK, nice! On the layout tabs, there are two modes, paper space and the model space. At this moment, we are working on the paper, and you can notice that when you zoom or use the pen. Although, if I click on paper, or double-click inside the rectangle, I'm switching to the model space. You can notice it, because the rectangular area is now thicker, and you can see the view controls and the UCS coordinates. This time, you can see that I am zooming in or out just inside the project, and the paper remains statically in the same position. When we are on the paper space, we can edit the rectangular area where my project is displayed. This is called a viewport. We can change its position from its center or changing the size with the grips on the corners. Now let's hit Ctrl Z a couple of times to go back where I was before and switch to the model space again. Now we can set the scale for the viewport, which is actually the scale that we want to set for the drawing in this paper. Choose a scale from this list, and if you can't find it, it's possible to create a new one on custom. If the scale itself is not important and you just want to fit the entire drawing within the limits of the viewport, select Scale to Fit. Now in this example, I'm going to choose this scale. 1/32 inches to 1 foot. Finally, I double-click outside from the viewport. I'm again on the paper space. I'm going to resize the viewport in order to fit all the floor plan. Now, if I want to print this drawing, the viewport will appear on your paper and also in this pink color. What if I don't want to print it? There are two ways. First, make sure we are on the paper space, select the viewport, and look at the layer it belongs to. CPU. Let's open the layer properties. And now, on the CPU layer, I'm going to click on VP Freeze to hide the viewport. Another way is creating a new layer. Right-click here, select New Layer. Name it Viewport, for example. Then let's change the color of this layer to white on the mother space, which becomes black on the paper space automatically. Then select the viewport, click on this tab to change it to the layer viewport. Finally, you can hide it either on the view pip freeze or by switching off the layer. When we set a viewport to show a specific drawing with a specific scale, we realize that in a small distraction, we scroll the mouse wheel and it messes up all the scale. And then I have to go to the scale list and click again, in this case in 1 per 150, and select again the scale. However, there is a very useful tool here, which is this icon to lock the viewport. Now, even I am in the modal space, I can zoom or move in the same way as I was in the paper mode, but I can still draw or erase objects inside the viewport. Basically, I recommend you to lock all the viewports when you think you are not going to change them again. Write text and draw the title block on the paper. I mean outside of any viewport, as it's easier and more practical. First, it's text that we don't want to model, as it's only used for annotation. Second, the size that we specify is the paper height, in this case 5 mm, and I don't have to scale it like in the model space. The same thing applies for the title block. Just draw it on the paper. You can start drawing the borders, then the text using the paper height. In this case, after placing the first single line text, I want 4 of these with the same spacing. I can use here the command copy, then the option array. Type 4, and finally I can click again to confirm the position or insert a specific distance between objects. Between the objects. And then just change the names to the right ones. Okay, I'm going to take the opportunity to explain to insert an image to the layout. For example, if you want to add a logo of your company, it's easy. Go to the Insert tab, then click on Attach and select an image to import to this file. I'm going to select a cut in black logo, for example, just to show you how it works. We can insert the coordinates of the insertion point or specify it on screen. Click on OK, place the start point, I can click around here, then it looks like that the image is a bit large, but that's fine, just press Enter now, as we can scale it after with a reference. Use the command scale, select the image, click for the base point. Choose the option reference at the command bar. And then choose 2 points of a reference line to resize it. And this time I will not insert any length because I don't know it. I just moved the cursor in this direction and you can see a dynamic preview of the logo. As soon as it looks great, I can click to place it there. So simple. Let's continue. Now we are going to learn to add more viewports on the same paper. Usually the purpose of doing this is to show different drawings or a specific detail that we want to show on a smaller scale. Let's go to the Layout tab on the ribbon. Here we will create a new viewport by clicking on this icon. There are 3 ways: rectangular, polygonal and object. Let's go for rectangular. So, I'm going to draw a rectangle here. Then I double click inside it to switch to the model space. And this time we will use a custom view that we created in the previous chapter. I click on top Go to Custom Model Views and choose Detail 1. Now look how useful this can be, and I don't need to search for that. Next, I'm going to the scale list and I need to choose one. And I need to choose 1 per 50. And the reason that I decide to use this scale is because 1 per 50 is the same as 0.02, which is close to the value that I've got here. And you can see that the drawing didn't change that much. Double click to switch to the paper space and readjust the viewport by clicking on the grip stair. Ah, and don't forget to lock the viewport. Do not move it again. After, I can copy this text and place it below our new viewport. Select the text. I'm going to use this endpoint as my base point, and then click on this corner for the second point, in order to keep the same spacing towards the viewport. Then rename it with the correct text, and put the scale 1 per 50 again. Next thing, I am going to draw a circle here. Then, on the Layout tab, choose the option to create a viewport from an existing object. Then click on the circle to convert it to a viewport. And of course, this option only works for enclosed areas. Then, suppose what I want here is to zoom this specific part. Then, move the circle to a specific layer if you want, or change the color of the object. And then I can draw a small circle in the same place of the floor plan, to indicate that the detail is a representation of this part. And if you want, at the end, you can connect it with lines. Viewport colors. As usually, we work in AutoCAD with a dark background, and it's more comfortable to use light colors. However, when it's time to print a drawing, we often realize that the colors are too light for a normal paper. But that's not a problem, because there's an option to set up different colors just for printing. First, I need to go to the model space of this viewport, double-click inside, then go to the layer properties, and as you can see, next to the column color, there is another named VP color, which means viewport color. Basically, I can change this color to the one that I want to show in the viewport. Let's do it for furnitures. Choose the darker yellow, and this time it's much better. So then, you can do the same process for the layers that you want to print in a different color. That's everything. Thank you very much, and see you next time.